morning children, welcome to our class. In previous period, previous classes we discussed about our earth. In this manner how we discussed about how our earth was formed and internal structure of our earth. And now today we know more about our earth. This way we learn about the Earth's grid system. It's a grid system. That means we are in previous classes also can see saw the some lines drawn on the globe. Some lines are some horizontal lines and some are vertical lines. The middle part of that horizontal and vertical lines, there are some square parts also there. That squares are known as grid. So what about the importance of this grid? Why we drawn these lines on the globe? There are so many uses are there about of this grid. So today we discuss about that importance of grid and what are called latitudes and what are called longitudes, where these latitudes and longitudes drawn on the earth. The first one, latitudes. These latitudes are also known as horizontal lines. The middle of the earth, we can see on the globe, you can see on the globe, here is a line. Here is an horizontal line is round around this globe. This line divided this earth into two parts. Half of the part is in the northern side and half of the part is in southern side. So this line, this horizontal line is known as equator. This is 0 degrees latitude. Here is also there. This is equator, 0 degrees latitude. From equator to north pole and from equator to south pole, there are some lines drawn on this globe. These all lines are known as latitudes. These lines are parallel to equator. These are from equator to north pole, these lines are called northern latitudes, and from equator to south pole, these lines are known as southern latitudes. So from equator to north pole, this half part is, we can see this is as half ball. Like, because we know about this, our earth is like a ball. So in the from middle of this line, this half part is known as, because this is the northern pole and this is southern pole. From equator to north pole, this half part is known as northern hemisphere. Hemi means half. Sphere means our globe, our earth is in the shape of spherical shape. So this total spherical, this is half of the part only. So from equator to north pole, this half part is named as northern hemisphere. In the same way, from equator to south pole, this half of the part is named as southern hemisphere. So this is the structure of this latitudes. First one, middle of the latitude is known as equator, and there are some latitudes from north pole and from south pole. And these latitudes also, from equator to north pole, here are 90 latitudes drawn on this globe. And this 90th latitude of north pole and also 90th latitude of south pole, these both are not latitudes. These are only points. This is north point and this is south point. from equator to north point, these are totally 90 latitudes are there. And in the same way, from equator to south pole, here are also 90 latitudes. In this 90 plus 90, total 180 latitudes except equator. Equator is 0 degrees latitude. And after 0, here are 90 and here are 90 latitudes. This is equator. From equator to north pole, this is only northern side point only. 90 degrees north latitude is only a point. From equator to this northern pole, north pole, here are total 90 latitudes are drawn. In the same way, from equator to south point, the south pole, here are also 90 latitudes are drawn. Total 90 plus 90, 180 latitudes are there on the globe. In this 180, this equator is 0 latitude. This is not countable in this 180, except equator, here are 90, here are 90, total 180 latitude are there. The next one, this letter, this word, latitude, how this latitude name derived? This latitudo is a Latin word. This latitude is came from this latitudo of Latin word. Latitudo means width. Width of the, this is total width of the earth. So, because of that only, that latitude name derived. Then, on this globe, there are some special lines also there. Special particular lines mentioned on this globe. Those lines are, mostly we all know about this first one is the middle of the earth. This is equator. This is also one of the special lines. And then from equator to 23 degrees and of 23 and a half degrees north, and in the same way 23 and a half degrees south. Here are the 23 and a half degrees north and 23 and a half degrees south latitudes. These latitudes have special names are there. The northern latitude of 23 degrees and 23 and a half degrees is known as Tropic of Cancer. Means south latitude, 23 and a half degrees south latitude is known as Tropic of Cancer. And in the 66 and a half degrees north latitude is known as Arctic line, Arctic circle. And in the 66 and a half degrees south latitude is known as Antarctic circle. Why these lines have named separately? Because there is a reason is there. In next classes, we discussed very briefly about of that reasons, but now we know why that name, special names derived because of sunlight falling. Our earth always moving, from west to east. That is, we already know about that. That is called as Earth's rotation. Or Earth always rotates from west to east. From west to east. Always sun rotates from west to east. This Earth also some most traveling round the sun also. So, because that sun rays fallen on the earth in different areas and different ways. Because of falling of that sun rays, we name these particular lines. So, these because of the particular line areas on the earth, different temperature regions also form. Different types of climatic conditions. And some areas are become very cold areas and some are very hot regions. So this type how different regions are how different areas are in different climatic conditions, we will discuss in our next lessons. Now, these names, Tropic of Cancer, Tropic of Capricorn, Arctic Circle, Antarctic Circle, these names, because of these names as of only for sunlight falling pattern only, because of sunlight falling. So this is the structure of our earth, and there are some lines drawn on the earth. These lines are known as latitudes, and the middle latitude is called equator. This is a zero latitude. From equator to north pole, in the north this is only point. Here are 90 latitudes, and in the same way in the south point, from equator to south point, here are 90 latitudes. Total 180 latitudes are drawn on the globe. And from equator to north part, this is called the northern hemisphere, and equator to south part, this is called as southern hemisphere. And why these latitudes are useful to us? Why we drawn these on the earth? These latitudes are useful for us to identify the different temperature regions of the earth, and also different countries, different continents, location of different continents on the earth. Which continent is in the middle part of which latitudes? So we can easily identify the places of such areas, places of such continents, countries, and so many other uses also there because of these latitudes. There are some another lines drawn on the globe. These lines are drawn from north pole to south pole. These lines as in vertical lines. These are known as longitudes. These longitudes also derived a Latin word longitudo. Longitudo means length. These longitudes, length, so from north pole to south pole is total length, total reach north pole to south pole, drawn these lines on the globe. So these also known as half circles, because these are drawn from north pole to south pole only, not in the round to the globe like latitudes. Latitudes are drawn round to the globe, but these longitudes are only the half area only. So because these are known as half circles only, these half circles, these longitudes have another name also there, that is called meridian. Meridian means timeline. This is the most important for fix different countries' timings. So that only this is known as timelines, are called as meridians, and also these are half circles, and this name is longitude. These longitudes also, the same way as like 0 degrees latitude in the equator, in the middle of the earth, here is also 0 degrees longitude also there. And the 0 degrees longitude also goes through this London, 0 degrees longitude. And from this 0 degrees longitude, it has also one particular name. This is named as Greenwich. From Greenwich to half of the part, the eastern side of half of the part has some another name, and the western part has some another name. From Greenwich to this eastern side of half of this part is known as eastern hemisphere, and in the same way from Greenwich to western part, this western half of the part is known as western hemisphere. The same like northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere, from equator to north pole, this is known as northern hemisphere. From equator to south pole, this is called southern hemisphere. The same way from Greenwich to eastern side, half of the part is called eastern hemisphere. And from Greenwich to western half of the part is known as western hemisphere. These hemisphere, these differentiation of hemispheres are most useful to draw these maps and also to identify the different countries on the world. So we are all know about these hemispheres. From equator to north pole, this is northern because of its direction. This is north direction, so this is northern. And in the same way, this is southern. As like that, this from Greenwich to this is eastern side. So eastern side half part of the earth is known as eastern hemisphere, and east Greenwich to western part is called as western hemisphere. And from Greenwich, this is Greenwich is 0 degrees longitude. From Greenwich longitude to eastern side, here are 180 longitudes are drawn on the globe. This is Greenwich to here are 180 in eastern side. So these are known as eastern longitudes. Total eastern longitudes are 180. And from Greenwich to western side also 180 longitudes are drawn on the globe. These longitudes are known as western longitudes. These are also 180 longitudes are there. Total longitudes on the globe are 360 longitudes. From equator to prime antimeridian and also from Greenwich to antimeridian and Greenwich to antimeridian. Both sides, from eastern side and in western side, total longitudes are 360 longitudes. And these longitudes, 0 degrees longitude is Greenwich, and the opposite side of 0 degrees, opposite side means quietly opposite side of this Greenwich is 180 degrees longitude is known as antimeridian. This is prime meridian and this is antimeridian. 0 degrees Greenwich is called prime meridian. Opposite direction of Greenwich, that is 180 degrees longitude. 180 degrees longitude is known as antimeridian. So these lines useful for us for fixation of timings of different parts of the world. And the first starting we discuss about grid. How these grid system formed. Here are longitudes. You can see very easily here. This is Greenwich. And from Greenwich to this is eastern side and this is western side. From Greenwich to this eastern part of longitudes are called eastern longitudes. And the same way from Greenwich to western side of longitudes are called western longitudes. This half part is known as eastern hemisphere. And from Greenwich to this western half part is known as western hemisphere. The same way from equator to, you can see once again, this is equator. From equator to, this is north pole and this is south pole. From equator to north pole, this half part is known as northern hemisphere. From equator to the south pole is known as southern hemisphere. And in the same way, from Greenwich to this half part is known as eastern hemisphere. And from Greenwich to western side half part is known as western hemisphere. So in middle of these latitudes and longitudes, for example, we can draw some latitudes on this earth, on this globe. These are longitudes, means prime meridians, meridian lines, time lines. And these are latitudes. Latitudes are drawn in the round around the earth. These are circles. Each longitude cut across the each latitude. you can see on this blackboard, each longitude including this Greenwich also cut across all the latitudes of the globe. Each longitude cut across the each latitude including 0 degrees latitude equator also cut across by these longitudes. So middle of these latitudes and longitudes, here are some square parts form, some squares. You know square. Square is in your mathematics, you know about this square. So square is between of these latitudes and longitudes, this square form. What is the importance of this square? This is known as grid. What is the importance of this grid? This is mostly useful to us to identify the countries in the world, to identify the different temperature regions, different climatic condition areas. We can easily identify with the help of this grid. And a time also, in which country has a time zone, in which time zone is there. And different areas of location of different areas, and also different timings of such areas also we can easily identify with the help of these grids. So we draw these lines on our globe. Now I ask one question. Anybody can draw any lines, such type of lines, in any part of the land in your area or in your certain places, any place? Anybody can see these lines? There are no lines on the ground. In any part, there are no lines drawn on the land in any part. These are only imaginary lines. Only imaginary lines. Means imaginary lines. Because these are not drawn any part of the world. Only these lines are for identify the places, to identify the time zones. We can study about this earth. We draw these lines for our comfortable only. From Greenwich, here are some longitudes we draw on this blackboard. This is 15 degrees longitude. In between of zero longitude, here are total 15 longitudes are there. But because of difficult, we drawn only 15 degrees distance, we drawn some longitudes on this blackboard. So here is sun rays passes from 0 degrees longitude to 15 degrees longitude. This middle of this time nearly taken, for 1 degree distance time taken nearly 4 minutes. Sun rises passes 1 degree to another degree, this time taken 4 minutes. Thus, like this, from 0 degrees to 15 degrees, the sun rises traveling period is 15 into 4, means 60 minutes, means 1 hour. So in Greenwich, it's 12 noon. For example, it's 12 noon a time. The next 15 degrees longitude region, this 15 degrees longitude region, here is the time is 1 o'clock afternoon. And from 15 degrees to 13 degrees, here also 15 longitudes are there. The same way in this 15 degrees also 15 into 4 minutes, means 1 hour time. So 15 degrees to 30 degrees longitude region, here is time, another 60 minutes time. Maybe away, fast away. So here is time is 2 o'clock. Well, noon. And 30 degrees to 45 degrees. You can observe each and every longitude. Here is 15 minutes time is there. 15 longitudes are there. Each and every point. 15 to 30, 15 longitudes, 30 to 45, 15 longitudes, 45 to 60, 15 longitudes, because this is very difficult to draw each and every longitude on the blackboard. So I can draw these longitudes, the distance between 15 degrees, each and every longitude 15 degrees. So 30 degrees longitude to 45 degrees longitude, in middle also 15 longitudes. Total from Greenwich to 45 degrees longitudes, here are totally 45 longitudes or sunrises passed away already. So on the way in the here is the time is 3 o'clock. So each 15 longitudes distance, 1 hour time may be extended. The same way in the western side also. The western side also, sun rises past here straightly only. Now, for example, here straightly only. But in this back 15 degrees longitude region, the sun already just passing. The sun is not a straight way, rays are not there here. So in this middle of these 15 longitudes also, 1 hour time back is there. Up to Greenwich to here is only 11 o'clock only, because here also 15 longitudes are there. In each and every longitude, sun rays has taken 4 minutes. So after these 1 hour only, sun rays has passed here. After 1 hour. So now in Greenwich, here is 12 o'clock noon. The western longitudes, these are some back timings are there. So here is 11 o'clock. And 30 degrees western longitude. 30 degrees western longitude, here is only 10 o'clock in the morning. And the 45 degrees western longitude, here is 9 o'clock. Eastern longitudes are extended 1 hour, because already sun passes there. And the earth, because of earth moving from west to east, for example, you know here, from west to east, sun always moving. Here is 12 noon. And in this part, always 12 noon over. And then 1, 2, 3, maybe in some opposite direction, maybe it's night time also. In the western side, sun is not passing straightly, just only arriving. So these are morning timings are there, 9 o'clock. And up to 60 degrees of western longitude region, here is only 8 o'clock in the morning. So you can observe the 15 degrees of eastern longitude areas, here is 1 o'clock noon. It is only 15 longitudes distance from Greenwich. This is eastern direction. And the same way, western degrees of western longitude region, this is also western longitude distance there. But here is time is only 11 o'clock. So 15 degrees eastern longitude to 15 degrees western longitude, there is a time maybe 2 hours difference is there. 2 hours difference is there. So just like of this, we know Greenwich goes through England, London. And our 82.5 degrees eastern longitude also goes in the middle of our country. Our standard meridian of the world, Greenwich to our Indian standard meridian, 82.5 degrees eastern longitude. The time between of these both, 82.5 degrees means 82.5 degrees into 4. One longitude, the sun rises passes from one longitude to another longitude, the time nearly taken 4 minutes. So, from our country, 82.5 into 4 is equal to 330 minutes. So 330 minutes means the time is 5 hours 30 minutes. So from Greenwich to our Indian standard time, this middle of time is mostly 5.5 hours difference is there, Greenwich to Indian standard time. And then each and every longitude, each and I will here or we draw 15 longitudes distance between one line to another line. So here are 60, 75, 90, 105, the total 180 degrees eastern longitudes, and in the same way western also 180 degrees longitudes. The time also changes. Here is 12 noon and here is 3 o'clock, here is 4, 5, 6, this Indian standard length 5 and a half. Here is 7 evening, this is 8 o'clock, and this is night 9 o'clock, and here is 10 o'clock night, here is 11 o'clock, and here is midnight 12. And in the same way in the western longitude region also, from 60 degrees western longitude to 75 degrees western longitude, here is time also 1 hour back. Here is 7, morning 7 only. And the next 15 longitudes difference, here is morning 6 o'clock only. And the next 15 longitudes distance, here is 5 o'clock only. And then 4, early morning, and here is 3 o'clock. The 2 o'clock and the 1 o'clock, and here is midnight 12. So this is 180 degrees, this 180 longitude and this 180 longitude is same because our earth is in round shape. So here is 0 longitude, whether here is 12 noon, the time of 12 noon, the same direction of anti-meridian line, 180 degrees of anti-meridian, here is midnight 12 o'clock this day. So this is the different time zones of our world. And now today we discussed about these such topics like latitudes. Latitudes are drawn on the globe. These are horizontal lines. 0 degrees latitude is equator. And from equator to north pole and from equator to south pole, there are total latitudes are drawn on the globe. These are all used for identify the different places of the world. And then longitudes are also drawn from north pole to south pole. Each and every longitude cut across the each and every latitude. So these longitudes also known as meridians and also known as timelines. These for identify the different timing areas of different parts of the world, we can easily identify with the help of these longitudes. And the grid, middle part of these latitudes and longitudes, there are some squares formed there. The squares are known as grids. These grids are very useful to us for identify the different places, to draw the maps, to draw the countries and to identify the countries and also different time zones of the world. We easily use with these grids. And then different time zones. Each and every longitude sun rises passes nearly time taken nearly 4 minutes for each and every longitude. So on that way our total earth differentiate some particular time zones. So Greenwich is a 0 degrees longitude, and from Greenwich to the eastern side 180 longitudes. In the same way Greenwich to western side also 180 longitudes are there. These are eastern longitudes and these are western longitudes. From Greenwich to eastern side the time may be increases for each and every longitude 4 minutes time increases, and the same western side 4 minutes time decrease for each and every longitude. So because of that we differentiate some certain time. Now you can write these answers in your notebooks. The first one, explain the importance of grid system, how grid system is useful to us. You can write down briefly. The next one, if every state follows its local time, what problems would rise in our country? In our country, already we discussed about from Arunachal Pradesh to Gujarat, there is a very longest area is there, and nearly this total area may be in 2 particular time zone regions, but we followed one standard meridian only, so that because from east to west different actual timings are different. Arunachal Pradesh sunrises, first sunrises starts in Arunachal Pradesh, the last sunset in Gujarat. That there is a time between of these two parts, there is a most of time may be taken, but on such situation that states they followed their different timings. If any case, which type of problems arose, you can write your own way. Next one, largest latitude on the globe. The name of that largest latitude, it's in the middle of the globe. The name of that latitude. Another name of longitudes are another two names also there. So what are the names of that plant? And the names. And the last one, Indian standard meridian is. In which meridian line India follows as its standard meridian?